So usually what we find is that when we're digging these things out of the ground is that we'll find bits of the body and no head, and very, very rarely we'll find just a head, but unfortunately with no body attached. So this animal here that has a head with a body attached to it allows us to unravel some of that species diversity. So we'll get a much better understanding of how did these early members of this group called elasmosaurs evolve in the early Cretaceous period, and also how many species were there around at the time.